Yeah, so this is even harder when you break his leg because he'll just go into this frenzy. But don't worry, my friends can deal some damage. And we are infected already. Okay, he's getting ready for the barrage. So we can even count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, we need an ammo box. If you get caught by one, it's probably game over. So don't take the full force of one and just relax a bit. See, this is why you need friends in this battle. It can be done without the help of the minions, but it's a lot more terrifying. Eh, that was not my best battle, but you know, it's... It's kind of hard when everything scales with your level. Go away. But yeah, it's actually very easy to knock his leg off, but then you actually have a lot of problems killing all the minions and have a very low window of damaging him. So I guess you will need a lot of fire damage or a lot of minions. So if you don't have the skills that I used, just use the fire bullets, the good old fire bullets, maybe the hunter's mark and whatever else you have in your inventory at that point. Okay, that was a little bit of a rougher fight, so yeah. Unless you really want all the weapons in the game, don't try to be fancy with him. It's a lot easier to just DPS him down, instead of just fighting wave after wave of exploding mushrooms and then exploding mushroom balls from the sky. Anyway, that was such a such a fun boss fight the first time. But the more you fight him, the more you see that there is no actual pattern, so sometimes you'll just be hit by a random ball and then die. Yes, that's the risk of the game. Besides, I also wanted to see how the game scales, so this is still on normal, so if you play on normal, even if you are very high level, you'll still have a lot of problems killing the enemies. Yep, that was not fun at all. I died a few times just because I got hit by the ball of Spore Cloud. Now let's see the fabulous hammer. Oh, you have the fabulous hammer, right?
Alright then.
Petrified Maul, heavy impact, stagger damage.
I've got work to do.
By the way, some of the weapons are really redundant. For example, the Scrap War Hammer is almost useless. Petrified Maul and of course the World Breaker. So let me compare these two. This has a different howl.
I'm not in the mood for chat.
But it's basically the same model and the same thing. So why would you want stagger damage when you can just get the Worldbreaker hammer, which has a cooler roar and also does explosion damage, impact damage, so it will actually push the enemies away. So it will stagger and push the enemies back, so I don't understand why we have the heavy impact. I guess if you really hate something and you want it out of your way, then you can use it.
I'm not in the mood for chat.
Otherwise, the other hammer is better. But this one feels like it's burning. Okay, let's go into the light and prepare for the last part of the video. Okay, see you next time. Bye!